Ladies and gentlemen, you're joining us, XWF Shockwave 54, and before the drop, we've got Bruiser making his way down to the ring, and he will be in a singles match to open the show tonight. Who's he going against? Well, I know, but if I was to tell you, that would ruin the surprise, wouldn't it? So ladies and gentlemen, one half of the Tag Division Champions, Bronx Bunny, and Bruiser will be going against this man tonight in the opening contest, the Crusade's very own monster. Tsunami, the big bad wolf that is Tsunami. Never ever get on the wrong side of this guy. Look, I know Bruce is a strong man, but he's gotta fight this guy tonight. See you after the drop. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us. The opening contest is Tsunami versus Bruiser. And Bruiser trying to kick him. Tsunami caught his leg. Massive forearm smash there. Tsunami and a forearm smash again. Bruiser still on his feet, but not anymore. After a third brutal forearm smash by the monster that is Tsunami. Tsunami, Irish whip, bouncing Bruiser off the ropes. What he got in mind? He grabs the legs. Look at this. Bruiser manages to push away using those strong legs of him, throwing some punches, and Bruiser's got the boxing background, man, throwing these strikes into the side of the head, but they didn't have much effect. Tsunami, the strength of him! The strength of him! Oh my god, body slammed him down with tons of force for the cover. 1, 2, and a kick out on two by Bruiser, one half of the Tag Division Champions, Bronx Bunny. Bruiser's not staying down from a body slam, but Tsunami staying on the attack here. Bruiser, fireman's carry, lifts the big guy over, and this is Bruiser's opportunity to get back and look at, oh, look at that left hook. Irish whip from Bruiser, bouncing Tsunami off the rope, try to grab him, but Tsunami kneed him in the face. Tsunami, knee in the face again, and Bruiser goes down to the floor. Tsunami staying on the attack, man, kick to the abdomen. Look at this, another knee in the face, oh my god. Massive show of force. Bruiser blocks the kick, clothesline, and he takes the big man down. Do not underestimate the pure brawn strength of Bruiser. You know, Bronx Bunny built their career on just slugging people, and that ain't gonna change tonight. Bruiser just stomping the face of Tsunami to hell, man. Look at this, vicious. And this is what Bruiser's got to do if he's going to beat Tsunami. He's got to wear him down with these strikes. Torning Tsunami up. Goes to grab him. Tsunami kicks him in the abdomen. Tsunami, look at this, lifts him up. Oh my god, Tsunami! Oh my, modified spine buster. Throws the legs around. Absolutely vicious. So Tsunami just stamps on the abdomen of Bruiser. Lifting Bruiser up to his feet. Bruiser on a clothesline. He's fighting back with all his might. And another clothesline. Don't underestimate this guy off the rope. Title slam! Title slam! Caught him as he rebounded off the ropes. Tsunami gone for the cover. It's over. Lights out. 2, 3. Tsunami defeats Bruiser here tonight in the opening contest of XWF Shockwave 54. You know, Bruiser, he fought for it, man. He fought for it. But Tsunami is a monster. He's a machine. He's a beast. Oh, wait. Here comes Skinner from behind. Here comes Skinner from behind. Skinner with a back elbow. Knocking Tsunami off his feet and a crush chop. Look at this. Tsunami tries to line him. He ducks under it. Tsunami, title slam. Oh, my God. Taking out both members of the XWF Tag Division Champions, and Tsunami's picking Skinner up. Picking him up. Look at this. Just throws him over the top rope like a bit of trash in the wind. Tsunami domination, man. This is what he brings to the table of the Crusade. Wait a minute. Short Savage. He's got a sledgehammer. Tsunami, turn around. Savage goes for it. Tsunami blocks it. Oh, he hits him in the stomach with the handle. Tsunami title slam. Oh my god. What a way to open the show. Tsunami just leaving bodies everywhere. title slam on the no holds barred champion. Tsunami grabs Savage, throws him out the ring, and he tumbles to the outside. Oh my god. This is what Tsunami brings to the Crusade, man. Pure brute power. Sean Savage on the floor, man, and Tsunami's just looking down at him. Tsunami, man. Su-frickin-army. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining the show tonight. We're continuing our Women's Championship Tournament with the next round of matches. We've got Penny Jacobs versus Athena. That's going to be a very impressive match. We've also got Jinx versus Wicker. These two put on a great showing in the previous rounds of the tournament. I'm interested to see how their styles will clash. Let's have a little look at the run-in for the Women's Championship Tournament so far. As you can see, the women that have gone through are Banshee and Celestia, Athena, Penny Jacobs, Wicker, and Jinx. We're going to narrow that down to just four tonight. Also tonight, we're going to see Yashi Aldatori taking on Munger, and I wish this wasn't happening, but it is. You know, Munger attacked Yashi, and Yashi said on social media that he wants revenge. And ladies and gentlemen, that music right there is this guy right here, Reverend Al, the XWF Internet Champion, and he had a great, great match with Brendan X last show. Unfortunately, the finish right at the end was ruined because Hazard got involved and got Brendan X disqualified, which is why Brendan X is now on Reverend Al's 10 defend list. You know, I don't agree with it, and to be honest, knowing Reverend Al, I don't think he will agree with it either. But at the end of the day, it does count towards his 10 defend, and if Reverend Al can defend this title 10 times, he can cash in for a shot at the XWF World Heavyweight Championship. Reverend Al so far is putting in a great time with this title, and he's asking for a microphone. Let's see what he's got to say. And Reverend Al says, first of all, I want to address the main event last show. Brendan X and I, we had a great match. It was, however, ruined by an individual who goes by the name Hazard. My goal with this title reign is to give you an internet champion who delivers great matches. My goal is to be an internet champion who gives new hungry talent a chance to shine, but also gives you never-before-seen blockbusters like Reverend Al versus Luke Loins or Brendan X versus Reverend Al. However, both of them matches were ruined. It's not my fault, but I do want to make up for it. What's he saying? So he says, here's what I'm going to do. Hazard, you want to ruin my match last show? I'm going to bring down divine justice on you tonight. I challenge you to an internet title match. Oh my god! What the hell? Brendan X backstage just took Hazard out. Oh my god! Brendan X just going mad. You can tell he's really pissed off, man. He had a great match with Reverend Al. Who knows? Maybe Brendan X could have become the new internet champion, but he's just left Hazard as a wreck on the floor backstage. Reverend Al says, well, it looks like Hazard won't be accepting my challenge then. So it is now open to anyone out the back who's hungry. This is an opportunity for someone to put themselves out there right now. Interesting from Reverend Al. Wait a minute, I know this music. I know this music, but he's retired. Oh my, okay. This is Harry Mills Jr. This is the son of Harry the Hunter Mills, a guy that debuted in XWF towards the end, before he went on hiatus. He actually retired since then, but this is his son. This is his son's debut, Harry Mills Jr. And it's his debut here tonight in XWF, and he's going against Reverend Al for the Internet Championship. Reverend Al said, put yourself on the map. This guy's putting himself on the map. He is debuting against Reverend Al, an XWA legend. He is wrestling for the Internet Championship. I mean, what more can you ask for in your first match? This is a big chance for this guy to shine. Harry Mills, let's do it, man. You show us what you're made of. You show me what you're made of. You show Reverend Al what you're made of. You show those fans out there in the crowd what you're made of. You show those guys on the live chat or the guys watching that play that. You show them what you're made of, kid. Let's see what you got. Ladies and gentlemen, the XWF Internet Championship goes on the line. Reverend Al is defending the title here tonight on XWF Shockwave against this guy right here, Harry Mills Jr., the son of Harry the Hunter Mills. I'm interested to see what this guy brings to the table, man. You know, he's got some weight to him. He's got some size to him. He looks like he's going to really bring the fight. Let's see what he can do. Ladies and gentlemen, he goes to grab Reverend Al, but Reverend Al fights out. You can't just go straight in for the Reverend like that. A nice arm drag reversal from Harry Mills, but The Reverend is fighting back. Look at this. He tried to grab him, but Reverend rode him over. He's going to school the kid, man. He's going to school the kid. One, two, three. No. Oh, my God. He only just got out of that, though. This is the expertise of Reverend now. He's got an answer for everything. Going for a tie-up here. But the Harry to Hunter Mills pushes him away. Grabs him around the wrist. Irish whip. What's he got in mind? As Reverend now comes back. Look at this. Goes to grab him again. But Reverend now using this expertise to find his way out. Hoists him up onto his shoulders. Oh, Harry to Hunter Mills! DDT! Oh my God! Lifted him up. This is the strength advantage of this kid. One. Two. Just before the two there by Reverend now, I think Harry Mills has got to use this strength advantage because, let's be honest, I think Reverend now has got an answer for everything. But if Harry Mills can use his strength and size against him, this could be the effort. But Reverend now moves him off the ropes. Look at this. Uses the rope and just drives a knee into the chest cavity, really wearing down the abdomen and the chest cavity of Harry the Hunter Mills. Draws him back in on a shoulder block for the cover. That's one. Two, and a kick out just before the two. Me saying that Harry's got to use his strength. Reverend Dow asserting dominance by shouldering him down, you know. I said Reverend Dow's got every strength in the book, man. Textbook, submission, wrestling, striking, aerial, speed, everything. For the cover, one, two, and a kick out just from the before the three there. Following the knee to the combo with a combination clothesline. Very nice from Reverend Dow, picking Harry Mills up to his feet. Harry tried to run in, and Harry Mills gets a German suplex for his effort. And now Reverend Dow torning Harry Mills up. Definitely out of his depth, this kid, man. Look at this from Reverend Dow, twisting the arm, getting him into a hammerlock position. Harry Mills with an elbow in the face. This is his opportunity. He runs in and he spears the Reverend. He spears Reverend Dow. Beautifully done. Harry Mills staying on the attack as he picks him up. Kick to the abdomen. Harry Mills using his strength, using his heavy weight to an advantage. Turns to Reverend Dow and a beautiful, beautiful neck breaker. Shades of his father, Harry the Hunter Mills, for the cover. Leg hooked. One, two. Three and a kick out there by the Reverend Dow, the internet champion. Not enough to keep him down. Can you imagine if Harry Mills was to win the internet championship tonight and defeat Reverend Dow? What an accolade that would be. Harry runs in with a massive clothesline, crushing Reverend Dow like a freaking slinky. And he's picking Reverend Dow up and he's staying on the attack with another Irish whip into the corner. Runs in and another one of these clotheslines like a freaking freight train. This is bad, man. This is bad for Reverend Dow right now. These clotheslines crushing him. Comes in for a third one and he nails it. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. This could be over, you know. Three of those huge clotheslines. One, two, three. No. Reverend Dow kicks out. He's still the internet champion for now. Harry Mills, stay on this, man. You wanted this opportunity. Make the most of this. He's picking Reverend Dow up with a clothesline. Somehow recovering in a second clothesline. You want clothesline, son? Reverend Dow will give you clothesline, son. Into the corner goes Harry Mills. Reverend Dow runs in. Shoulder block. Oh, here it comes. Get the notepad ready. Belly to belly suplex! Expertly done from the Reverend as he is torn in. Harry Mills up to his feet. Harry Mills doesn't know where he is. He tries to clothesline him, but it's too slow. Back suplex from the Reverend. Lifting him up. German suplex from the Reverend lifting him up. How does he have this energy, man? Spins him around. Look at this. Look at this. Beautiful vertical suplex. Nailing Harry the Hunter Mills down, and Reverend now sees an opportunity. He sees an opportunity, he's going up top. Harry Mills, if this hits you, it's lights out, man. Leap of faith, and he nails it. He nails the leap of faith on Harry the Hunter Mills for the cover. One, two, three, and Reverend now defends and retains the XWF Internet Championship here tonight on XWF Shockwave 54. But please, I think we've got to give it up for the debut of Harry Mills Jr. right there. He had a great match with a legend in his debut, and Reverend Dow putting his hand out. See, this is what Reverend Dow's title reign is about, man. Matches like that, giving guys opportunities to wrestle with one of the greatest we've ever known for a title opportunity to get themselves seen. And Reverend Dow, I mean, he will have a good match with anyone. Here's the 10 defense status of Reverend Dow here tonight. Zebro, Luke Loins, Brendan X, Harry Mills. Great match there from Reverend Dow. He continues to be a great XWF Internet Champion. And man, I know you're upset about some of your matches having some screwy finishes and stuff, but that ain't your fault, man. You continue doing what you're doing, and I think the XWF locker room and fans and me and everyone will appreciate it. Still to come tonight, ladies and gentlemen, Penny Jacobs versus Athena and Jinx versus Wicker, which are both part of our ongoing Women's Championship Tournament. There's the brackets there if you missed it earlier. Also to come tonight, We've got Yashi Aldatori versus Munger. I feel like this is a lamb to the slaughter, but Yashi's got to do what he's got to do. And we're moving on, ladies and gentlemen. As Penny Jacob, speaking of second generation superstars, we just saw Harry Mills Jr. Now we're seeing Penny the Python Jacobs, the daughter of Mike the Viper Jacobs. And every time I see this woman in the ring, and not even in the ring, just walking down like this, look at her face, look at her attitude, look at her body language. It radiates of that Jacobs family heritage, man. She's got the same attitude, she's got the same execution, she's got the same skill set. Everything, all of those qualities that you see from the legend that is Mike the Viper Jacobs, I see exhibited by this young lady right here, Penny the Python Jacobs. And I think this woman could go all the way in the tournament, but she has potentially got the biggest roadblock, the biggest roadblock in the tournament ahead of her tonight. But she does not seem fazed. Any other woman would be worrying. Penny Jacobs looks just as focused, just as ready, as she always does. No fear in the eyes of this woman, ladies and gentlemen, even if she is facing Athena. And let me tell you, the only time we've ever seen these two in the ring was in the XWF Women's Championship, ceremonial championship even, tournament on XWF Shockwave 46. Penny Jacobs decimated Banshee, and this woman right here came out and chokeslammed Penny Jacobs into next week for the one, for the two, for the three. And every time we have seen Athena in XWF, she has decimated people. She has destroyed people. She has literally pulled their bones from their freaking sockets. She has torn them apart. And it has been vicious and it has been violent, and no one has managed to faze this woman. Penny Jacobs has got to use all of her expertise tonight if she's going to topple this giant. Do I believe she can do it? I think Penny Jacobs got more chance than anyone else in the tournament. Ladies and gentlemen, Athena versus Penny Jacobs, XWF Women's Championship Tournament, and here we go. Penny Jacobs using agility to slide through the legs for the schoolboy roll-up. Can she steal it? One, and a kick out on one by Athena. It's not enough. Athena trying to get up to her feet. Penny Jacobs lifts her up, grabs her. Oh, Athena pushes her over. Oh my God, the strength in this woman. Picking Penny Jacobs up to her feet. Look at this, try to grab her. Penny using her speed. Penny with the schoolboy again, sliding her down. She's trying to steal it. She's got a battle plan. One, and a kick out on the one by Athena. It's not enough, but Penny Jacobs knows what she's got to do. Look at this, tries to grab her, but Athena throws her over her shoulder. And this is the strength of Athena. Left punch, left hook, man, vicious. Irish whip throwing Penny off the ropes. What she got? Belly to belly, no! Bell clap there from Penny Jacobs. Kick to the abdomen. DDT on the Athena, on the big woman. This is what Penny Jacobs, she's taking a fight to her, goes for the Irish whip. Athena reverses it, runs in, massive punch to the face from Athena, massive punch to the face from Athena, and look at this, elbow in the side of the head, elbow in the side of the head, and Penny Jacobs crumbles down. Athena off the ropes, look at this, leg drop on the throat. Oh my God, Penny Jacobs isn't moving. One, two, three, no, Penny Jacobs gets her shoulder up, pushes her up violently. She's not down for the count yet, but Athena's staying on the attack and she picks her up to her feet. Look at this. Look at this. Goes for a backbreaker, but Penny Jacobs reversed it with a backflip. Look at this. Snap suplex on the big woman. Beautifully done. I'm telling you now, Penny Jacobs, man, for the cover. One. And a kick out on one. Did you see that backbreaker, man? Athena put in her backbreaker and Penny Jacobs backflipped out of it. Absolutely incredible technique. Going for a punch, but Athena blocks it and pays her back in kind with a forearm smash. Headbutt, and Penny Jacobs crumbles down. Athena just taunting her, and Penny Jacobs using the ropes to climb up. You can tell she's already really feeling this fight. Look at this, back suplex from Athena, like a ton of bricks driving into the back. Lateral cover for the pin. One, two. Could she? Oh man, I thought she was gonna have her, but a kick out on 2.5 there from Penny Jacobs. Every time Athena gets in this ring, she dominates. Even the most dominating wrestlers get dominated. Look at this. Oh my God, a chop on the skull. Vicious. Picking Penny Jacobs up again, and Athena with another one of these chops. Oh my God, and Penny Jacobs, look at this, she's fighting back. She got out of it, belly to belly suplex, just as Athena was trying to pick her up to throw one of those chops for the cover. One, two. Man, I'm telling you now, belly to belly and suplexing a woman of that size is an impressive feat from Penny Jacobs. She's got the techniques, used her body weight to leverage just right to lift her up, going for an Irish whip, but Athena reverses it and turns Penny Jacobs around into the corner. And look at this, using that big foot to choke and just crush the skull like a freaking lemon. Wait, Penny Jacobs pulling the leg away. Look at this. Swoops her legs out with a leg behind her. Beautifully done, Penny Jacobs, for the style STO. No, and a kick out just before the one. What have you got to do to keep this woman down? I'm scared of this woman, but Penny Jacobs is fighting. Her results, he headbutted her, man. Penny Jacobs, she will fight till the fight ends, mate. She will fight till the fight ends. European uppercut again into the corner. Penny Jacobs clubbing Athena. I don't think we've ever seen anyone take the fight to Athena like this. Kicking the leg. Penny Jacobs using the ropes to give her more strength and more momentum with these kicks. And now Penny Jacobs goes for it again, but Athena kicks out and runs in and bulldogs her. Oh my, nothing seems to faze this woman. She's torn Penny Jacobs up, and Penny, if you don't find a way out of this, this is good night for you. Oh my god, she puts her up onto her shoulders. Look at the crushing force. Samoan drop. Oh my god, lights out for Penny Jacobs. One, two, three, no! Penny kicks out. Somehow she dug down deep. Athena just staying on the attack. No, she just does not stop. She's on relentless, going on for another Samoan drop. Look at this ton of force. Oh my god. Another Samoan drop for the cover. One, two, this is it. Three, Penny gets a shoulder up again. She's digging down deep. She will not die. She will not stay down, but Athena picks her up again. Oh, this is just going to go on until you die, man. No, she's finding out the small drop. Oh, reverse forward falling DDT. Exactly what Penny Jacobs needs. This is her chance to get back in the driver's seat. Picks her up and a clothesline from Penny Jacobs, running in so much body weight behind it. Under the arm, Penny Jacobs. Oh, she runs into a DDT. Athena just ran in, jumped her body weight into a DDT and crushed the skull and spinal column. And look at the strength of this. Crushing down with a rib crusher. Any momentum that Penny Jacobs build up is killed in an instant. Stop dead, bang, brick wall. Athena picking Penny Jacobs up to her feet, Irish whip in the corner. Just look at Athena. She's pointing at her. She's mad, man. She's angry. She's running in. Penny Jacobs moves out the way. Athena goes back first into the turnbuckle. And this is Penny Jacobs. Oh my god! It's three turner suplex! The signature maneuver of Penny Jacobs. I can't believe she just nailed that on Athena, man. And Athena trying to lift herself up on the ropes. She's rocked from that move. Here comes Penny Jacobs. Penny Jacobs close on over the top rope. Athena on her feet somehow. Penny Jacobs off the ropes. Dives through the rope. Oh, forearm smash. And she takes Athena down. Oh, my God. I'm getting goosebumps, man. She just reminds me of Mike Jacobs so much. Everything she does, she's got a battle plan no matter who she's fighting. What a move, man. What a dive through the ropes from Penny Jacobs after an extreme tiger suplex for the cover. One, this is it. Two, this is it. Three, no, Athena kicks out. What have you got to do to keep this woman down? What have you got to do to keep this woman down? Penny Jacobs staying on the attack. Her resolve is strong. Clothesline, she's fighting back in another clothesline. Athena up to her feet, ducks the clothesline. Penny Jacobs, oh, and Athena cuts her down with a clothesline. So much body weight behind it, and Athena torning her up. Nothing stops her. Nothing freaking phases her. Oh no, she's got a hand around the throat. This is over for Penny Jacobs. Not like this, not like this. Penny Jacobs reverses it into a falling forward STO pay dirt style. She's picking her up. This is her chance. The Pythonplex. She's got it. But no, Athena knees her in the top of the head. Not like this. Athena Irish whip into the corner. Runs in. She grabs her. Oh no, no. Penny, you got to find a way out. Hoist her up. We saw this on charity. Buckle bomb. Oh my God. Oh my God, the humanity. I felt it. We all felt it in the arena. And Penny's trying to get up to her feet. Athena does big hands around the throat. And Penny's so dazed. She doesn't know where she is. Oh my God, she lifted her up. Oh, choke slam. For the cover. One, two, three. And Athena defeats Penny Jacobs. Penny Jacobs took her, man. Penny Jacobs went. She went. She had a battle plan. She literally delivered battle plan step by step by step by step by step. But it wasn't enough. Athena is a machine. She is dominant. Who can stop her in this tournament, man? I think we're looking at the women's champion. Who can stop this freaking woman? If you see what she just took from Penny Jacobs and she's standing there like nothing even touched her. Athena goes through in the women's championship tournament. She joins Banshee and Celeste. We're putting one more person through tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm buzzing. That was a great match. We're going backstage. Titus Valentine here, and he says, "Damage and Damage Inc., your so-called reign of terror needs to come to an end. Everyone, the locker room, the fans, they're all bored of it now. Every week, it's the same shenanigans. You jump in people before and after matches. I think it's time to topple Damage Inc., so here's a challenge to Bronx Bunny. me and Kamikaze want your tag division titles, and it's time that we dethrone you. Oh my god, time's Valentine. He says, it's time that we restore the tag division to its former glory with proper fighting champions. He says, it doesn't matter where or when, we are taking them titles. Let's go! Titus pumped up, man. And wait, the owner's here now, and the owner says, Titus, it's funny you should say that, because we have a CPV on the horizon. XWF fans, you may have seen the teasing on XWF social media, but let's make it official. Our next CPV will be called Boiling Point. Oh my god, it's official, man. Boiling Point is our next CPV. And the owner says, I think it's time that we start building a card. So the first official match for Boiling Point will indeed be Johnny Kamikaze and Titus Valentine versus the Bronx Bunny for the XWF Tag Division Championships, but the titles will swap hands on a DQ, so there's no easy way out for the Bronx Bunny. Oh my god, the Bronx Bunny can't cheat this time. Boiling Point, the Crusade, and Bronx Bunny for the tag titles. And the owner says, I will be adding more matches soon, but for tonight, for now, let's move on with the show. Ladies and gentlemen, we got our first match for CPV. I'm looking very much forward to that. And oh, we're moving on. Ladies and gentlemen, man, look, listen. Gashi Auditori had a great match with Junction last show, okay? Junction said he wanted an open challenge. He wanted someone to put themselves out so that he and them could prove to the XWF fans and management that they can go and put on great matches and move up the card. Now, I appreciate everything that Junction did for this guy. They had a great match. Gashi's been seen as a joke throughout the years of XWF. He came out here and he proved that he's got some wrestling chops. And then Munger attacked him for no reason. No reason whatsoever, man. And Yashi won't let that live down. Yashi had to come out here and he won't let it live down. Yashi came out and confronted Munger last show and it didn't end well for him, man. It did not end well for him. Oh man, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, the opponent for Yashi Auditori is this man right here, this Munger. Just look at him. Chiseled, man. He's like a Greek freaking god. He doesn't even look human in some ways, man. And this guy is a battering ram of epic proportions. This guy destroys. This guy dominates. This guy is destruction embodied in the form of a human body of flesh and meat and bones. And he just goes out there and he drives through people. This guy beat Nightmare at No Turning Back. This guy is destroying people left, right, and center. And Yashi Auditori is taking it on himself to stand up to this guy. And he's in the ring, man. He's not backing down. Ladies and gentlemen, Yashi Auditori versus Munger here tonight. Shockwave 54. Munger clothesline! Oh my god, I mean, I don't know what to say, man. Yashi's got heart and soul, and I appreciate him. But look at this. Look at this. Munger just throwing him. Oh my, he didn't even try. He didn't even try, and Yashi holding his back in pain. Munger picking him up. This is not looking good for Yashi. Munger, oh no, not this, not this. No, Munger, oh my god, suplex slam just throws him. This signature style suplex of Munger, it's just vision. Oh, not again. Under the arm, look at this. Munger slamming him down. He's just walking around. He's just enjoying it. Yashi doesn't even know where he is, man. Not a third one, please. Not a third one. Oh my god, he's just throwing him down like a bad conversation. Gotta cover one, two, it's over. Three. Oh my god, Yashi, just stay down, man, please. Please stay down, man. You're just bringing more pain on yourself. This is hard to watch, man. Munger with the Irish whip throwing Yashi into the corner. Look at Munger running in. Yashi gets an elbow up. He's fighting back. Yashi runs in, knees him, but he doesn't fall over. Yashi runs in, knees him again, but he doesn't fall over. Yashi fighting. Oh my god, he closed on him. Knocks him over, back elbow. Yashi's fighting. Yashi's fighting, man. Reversing the whip. Munger. Oh, and he knees him in the abdomen. Cut it short. Momentum dead stopped, man, and Munger's torning him up. This is not looking good for Yashi. Yashi, oh my god, shrimp pin. He's rolled him up. Look at this, he's grabbing the legs, he's grabbing the hands. One, two, he's gonna get him. Three, no, Munger kicks out. Oh my god. Munger, Yashi going for him. Munger picks him up. Munger picks him up. Bicep of God, oh my god, just like that. Just like that. Yashi walked straight into it, didn't see it coming. Leg hook for the cover. One, two, three, and it's over. Munger literally was playing with his food, and the second that Yashi nearly pinned him and caught him by surprise, bicep of God! Literally, Yashi caught him by surprise and he nearly pinned him. Munger kicked out and Munger snapped. That was it, bicep of God, game over, good night. Look at Munger's face. He knows how dominant he is. That's what makes it scary. is that he knows no one can stand up to him at the moment. Whoever stands up to him, he just drives through them like a train, man. He drives through them like a wrecking ball, just through a building, through an old decrepit building, just crashing through it. That's what Munger does to these people. No remorse as well. You look in his eyes, he doesn't have remorse. That's the scary thing about Munger, man. And I don't know who physically can stop this guy. That's what's scary. Ladies and gentlemen, we're moving on for tonight's show. So buckle up, get ready, and let's see what we're moving on to next. Ladies and gentlemen, still to come tonight, we got Jinx versus Wicker as part of our Women's Championship Tournament match. I'm interested to see how that one rolls out. We're backstage now with Dr. Karn, and Karn says, I know the owner has started booking towards Boiling Point, but I feel like this has to end now. Damage, I'm challenging you to a match tonight in the main event for the XWF World title. And if you're a real man, if you're a real champion, you'll be there for the ass-kicking that you deserve. And that is what the doctor ordered. Oh my god, Dr. Karn challenging Damage for a match tonight. Main event for the title. Interesting. Interesting. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. You know whose music that is. Treble is making her way down to the ring. The XWF ceremonial champion. And Treble has been just driving through, man. She's been on fire since she came to the XWF. She made her debut XWF Shockwave 46 in the Women's Ceremonial Championship Gauntlet match. And since then, she won the title, and she has defended it over and over again. Charity, Handy Mandy, Taryn Knox, Hamako, Marie Gonzalez, Leticia Lopez, Helena Hart. She is building these defenses up. Any challenger, Treble drives through them. And that Treble Maker, man. If she hits the Treble Maker, she literally just, it's game over, man. Every time she hits it, you feel the power of that move throughout the arena, and it's game over. It's game over, and Treble's getting the microphone here. And Treble says, I'm going to cut straight to the chase. Ceremonial Championship Open Challenge. I dedicate this next victory to Miss Fortune, as we all know that she can't get her own victories. Oh my god, she's ruthless. She says, so whoever wants to take up the challenge, let's just get this over with. Man, Miss Fortune should take the challenge for that one, man. Miss Fortune should take the challenge for that. And Treble's just waiting for a competitor. And who's it going to be? And wait a minute. I don't know this what the hell? Yui? Ladies and gentlemen, this is the debut of Yui. I've heard a lot about this woman. We've heard a lot about her. She's called the Princess of Strong Style. She's still fairly new to the UCT. But she's been putting in some impressive workout stuff, man. I've been seeing people posting about her on social media. And she's here tonight. Now, this is something that, as far as I'm aware, Treble has not accounted for. You know, you can know all the women on the roster. You can account for their styles, and you can do your homework. How do you homework someone who you've never seen wrestle? How do you homework someone you've never wrestled either? Yui is a wild card here tonight, man, and I wasn't expecting this. You know, don't get me wrong, Treble will not be phased at this. To Treble? This woman right here is a red crosshair that says Treble Maker. Like any other woman that gets in the ring with Treble. But Yui looks aggressive, man. This is a big chance for Yui to put herself on the map here tonight in XWF. Could you imagine if after all these title defenses that Treble has had, after this dominant performance after dominant performance after dominant performance after dominant performance, if this woman right here was to take her out tonight, that would be a big, big impact. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, I wasn't expecting this. We're starting off with our ceremonial championship right here tonight. The new title there, as demonstrated on screen. And Treble will be defending it against Yui. And Treble holding the title up. And this is the thing with Treble. She always looks ready. She always looks focused. She does not ever show fear. She does not ever show concern. She always looks ready. But look at the face of Yui, man. She looks just as ready, I'd say. I'm interested to see Yui. I'm going to, hands up, I'll be honest, I've seen her training videos. I've not seen Yui in a match. You know, I apologize if I haven't seen her. It's just the way it is. Yui coming over now. These girls locking horn. Who's going to be stronger, the girl? Who's going to be, Yui spinning around with the arm there. Wrist lock. Wait, Treble moves it up. Treble's got chops, man. Puts her up into a top wrist lock. Knee in the stomach. See, this is vicious from Treble. trying to wear her down, but Yui turns it into a hammerlock and then into a side headlock. Look at this, putting her weight on Treble, trying to wear her down. Treble digging her toes into the canvas, pushing Yui back. Bounces her off the rope. Yui releases off the rope. Treble grabs the arm, tries to arm ring her, but Yui with a fist in the face. Yui with a run in and a drop kick, taking Treble off her feet. This is Yui's opportunity to show what she is, to show who she is, and show what she can do with these vicious strikes. There's a reason they call her the Princess of Strong Style, and she turns Treble around, but Treble grabs her by the hair and puts her in. You want the Strong Style? Here's some knife edge chops on Treble, punching the abdomen. Treble kneeing in the stomach, kneeing in the stomach, kneeing in the stomach. Look at her. Just grabs her by the head and slams her down. This is what I'm saying. Treble will fight you, man. Treble's a freaking lion. She's a tigress. Lioness. And if you want to fight her, she will fight you. She will fight you driving the knee into the leg and just wrapping her legs around and striking the knee joint, striking the kneecap. She will pick you apart like a vulture picks flesh off bones. Treble with a double stomp and then a kick in the chest. Leg hooked for the cover from Treble. 1, 2, and a kick out on 2 there by Yui. Really interested to see Yui here tonight on XWF Shockwave 54. Wasn't expecting it, wasn't account for it. Yui reversing that clothesline. Look at this innovative rope pin. Pulls her through, legs over the arms. 1, 2, she's going to pin a champ. 2, kick out just before that 3. Just before that 3, but Yui's in the opportunity. Yui's in the driver's seat. Draws her back and a knee in the stomach. These two are fighting, man, and I'm liking it. Look at this, Yui puts the arms in. Look at this hatch style. Hatch style suplex as he launches Treble. Launches Treble, man. Impressive. Leg hook from Yui for the cover. 1, 2. And a kick out on 2 there by Treble, the ceremonial champion. You're going to have to do more, Yui. You're going to have to do more. Yui with a forearm smash. And another one viciously done. Yui pulling Treble out. Look at this. Look at this. Steps up. Oh, and drives a knee into the forehead of Treble. Jesus Christ. Bounced off the second rope to give her the height she needed. And look at this. Look at this. German suplex from Yui. Oh, my God. That was vicious, man. Leg hook for the cover. Yui, new ceremonial champion. 1, 2, 3. No, Treble kicks out. It's not enough. Treble on the ropes here, man. That German suplex really rocked her, really shook her. And Yui staying on the offense. Another forearm smash into the ropes. Look at this. Pulls her out. Look at this. Jumps over. Look at this. Yui with a cross body, cutting Treble down to size. For the cover again. 1, 2, 3, and Treble kicks out. But how much force and exertion of energy is she using to repeatedly kick out of these moves that Yui is throwing at her? Yui picking Treble up to her feet. Kick to the abdomen there, and kick to the abdomen again. These kicks are violent, man. Look at this, throwing the arm over. Yui with a suplex. Look at this, Treble rolls over the back of her. Treble drives a knee into the back. This is the opportunity Treble needs. She only needs one, man. She only needs one. You want a suplex, says Treble. Look at this. Falcon Arrow spins her around and drives her down to the mat with huge force. Game-changing maneuver. Treble staying on the attack as she picks Yui up to her feet. Treble with a clothesline, driving her down. Clothesline again on Yui. Off the rope, calf kick from Treble. Yui wiped out. This could be over. Retention for the title. 1, 2. Treble retains. 3. No, Yui kicks out. Oh, my God. What a debut from Yui here tonight on Shockwave 54. Treble picking Yui up to her feet. Treble staying on the attack. You want a forearm smash. Well, there's one in your face for good measure. And a second one. Yui calls herself Princess of Strong Style. Well, Treble's fighting that right now. She's fighting it, man. Goes for a third one, but Yui arm drags her over. Whilst Yui got in mind, pulls the leg out. Look at this. Treble pushes her away, though. Yui was going for something. But she spins around as Treble gets up to her feet with a kick to the abdomen. Irish whip off the rope. Massive calf kick. You want a calf kick? There's a second one. Treble going for a clothesline, but Yui ducks under it. Neck breaker with precision from Yui. Yui off the rope. Lioness salt. Oh, my gosh. He nails it. For the cover. For the cover. 1, 2, new ceremonial champion. 3, no, Treble kicks out. Oh my God, the signature maneuver of Yui. The signature maneuver, and it's not enough to keep her down, but Yui's torn in her up. She's got to go bigger. What you got in the tank, Yui? What you got to show us? Look at this, going for the leg. I don't know what she's going for, but Treble reverses it by spinning around, holding the arm at arm's length. Look at this wrist lock. Yui feeling that as she elbows her in the joint. Treble right here. Oh my, just like that. Yui turned around straight into it. She nails it for the cover. 1, 2, 3, man, what a match. Treble retains again, but Yui in her debut looks extremely strong and shows what she can bring to the table. Treble adds another defense. 8 defenses. Charity Hurley, Mandy Taran, Max Hamako, Marie Gonzalez, Leticia Lopez, Helena Hart, and now Yui. Treble's dominance path continues. Treble putting in some of her best work, man. Some of her best work from Treble. and she continues to dominate. She's making this title what it is, man. She is the first ceremonial champion, and this is going to be a title reign to remember so far. Miss Fortune! Miss Fortune just came back! Oh my god! Bullet time in the face! Treble, man, you prodded the bee's nest, you prodded the wasp nest, and Miss Fortune's just looking at Treble after she receives a bullet time right in between the eyes. Treble wasn't expecting it. She was celebrating. And oh, Yui's trying to get up to her feet now. What a great match. Wait, wait, Miss Fortune, don't do it! Miss Fortune, bullet time on Yui! Oh my god! Miss Fortune is pissed, man. Two bullet times. She just wipes the hell out of Treble. Yui has nothing to freaking do with it. She bullet timed her face off into next week. Oh my god, Miss Fortune just leaving. Miss Fortune just leaving. Well, she certainly left her mark on the ceremonial champion, that's for sure. Wow. Wow, ceremonial champion taken out at the hands of Miss Fortune and Yui, who did nothing to deserve it. Ladies and gentlemen, still to come tonight, we've got Jinx versus Wicker in the next round of our Women's Championship Tournament. Here's the running so far. As you can see, Banshee and Celestra are through. Athena is through. And tonight, either Wicker or Jinx will go through. And I'm actually hearing that we're going backstage now. And it's Damage. And Damage says, Karn, you've always got what you want over the years, but not anymore. Now that I'm the champion, you don't just get title shots for nothing. No, 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 no. Not when there is a whole roster of hungry wrestlers who all want a shot at me. And Damage says, if you want to be in the main event tonight, that's fine, but you will not be wrestling me. What's he saying? And Damage says, because I spoke to an old friend, someone who thinks he deserves a main event. Who's he talking about? And Damage says, and he's agreed that he's going to put you down tonight, and his name is Jacob Drake. Oh, what the hell? Okay, so we got a main event planned now. Dr. Karn will be taking on Jacob Drake in the main event here tonight. Interesting. Interesting. Jacob Drake feels like he's got a lot to prove. Well, you're fighting royalty, man. XWF legend. We're moving on now to our next match in the Women's Championship Tournament. And Jinx is making her way down to the ring. And we saw her first ever match and debut in XWF in the Women's Championship Tournament first round, and she put in a great, great match against Helena Hart. And I think the fans have really gravitated towards Jinx. There's something very likable about her, her unorthodox moveset. You know, you just can't help but root for this woman. But she's got a big challenge ahead of her tonight because she's facing the unrelentless Wicker. And we saw what Wicker could do to Handy Mandy. And I don't want Jinx to end up like that, man. Because I like this girl. I like this woman. I think she brings a lot to the table. And I think Jinx is... She knows what's on the line. She got through the first round. And she's here tonight to do the second round. But oh my god, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, I mean... The atmosphere in the arena changes. I can't explain it. I can't describe it. But... I mean, the hairs on my arms. I know it's coming. That's the thing. I know this entrance is coming. But you look at this woman, you hear that music, the lights go low, and there's something surreal about it, man. I don't believe in different dimensions. I don't believe in, you know, I don't believe in supernatural. But this is something that, it's something tribal. It's something, I can't explain it, man. You gotta be there. It's something very unresting, and it stirs me up in a weird way, man. I think she knows it, and it's part of her, and she brings it down. But you look in the eyes of Wicker, man, and it's just empty. It's soulless. There's nothing there. And when she gets in the ring, she dominates. You know, we've seen it time and time again. Wicker is an absolute force of nature. And it's a very different take on how we see Jinx. You know, Jinx is very upbeat, very happy-go-lucky, jumping around all fast and agile, and I think she's going to have to use that speed advantage to her ability, man. Because the thing with Wicker is she's big, she's strong, but she's not held back by, like, she's not slow for her size, man. She's big and she's fast. That's what makes Wicker dangerous. It's an interesting matchup, and I'm interested to see how this goes, but, you know, Jinx... You gotta use everything you've got. You gotta use everything in your weapons cabinet. You gotta use everything in your toolbox if you're gonna overcome this challenge. And it's a big, big challenge. Ladies and gentlemen, Women's Championship Tournament rages right here, right now. Shockwave 54, Jinx, Wicker, let's go. Oh my god, Wicker just grabs Jinx around the throat. Jinx is trying to get out of it. Oh, a punch to the abdomen, vicious. Oh my god, look at this, headlock and just punches her. Jinx goes down, she's trying to stay on her feet. Club to the back, club to the back. Double X handle, she's still standing. Double X handle, she's not standing. Oh man, this could be one-sided, man. This could be one-sided as Wicker picks Jinx up and hits her in the face, and Wicker turning her around with the force of that punch, double axe handle into the turnbuckle. Oh my god. Jinx doesn't know where she is. Punch to the abdomen, punch to the abdomen. Wicker is a force, man. Clothesline, clothesline, clothesline. Oh my god, pull around the clothesline. The force. Vicious. It could be over, man. Could be over. One, two, three. Jinx gets her shoulder up. At least she's still alive. At least she's still fighting. Jinx, you've got to dig down deep, man. You've got to find a way out of this. You really have. Wicker, look at the strength of her. Picking her up in a military press. Look at the strength. Oh, Jinx rolls through. Sunset flip pin style for the cover. She's going to steal it. One, two, three. No, Jinx, not enough. Wicker kicks out with the force of her legs. Jinx goes for a punch, but Wicker just jumps into her. Look at that, slamming her down by the head. Picking her up by the head, slamming her down again. Picking her up by the head, slamming her down again. Oh my god, Wicker is a monster, man. Jinx trying to get up to her feet and just receives a kick in the back for her worries. Sitting up and a kick in the back again. Wicker is ruthless, man. Wicker is aggressive. She's violent. She's dominating. Punch in the face. Jinx turns around. Look at this. Lifting Jinx up. The body weight of her. She's nothing. Slams her down with a shin breaker, man. This is hard to watch. Wicker picking Jinx up. Punches her into the corner. Punch to the abdomen again. Punch to the abdomen again. Wicker grabbing the arm. Just using her strength to Irish whip her into the corner. Wicker runs in. Jinx with an elbow. Jinx flying clothesline. Look at the strength. She puts all her body weight in. That's what she needs. Jinx picking Wicker up to her feet. What she got in mind? Punch, punch, punch. These little back chops. Punch in the face. Back fist. Wicker goes down. Jinx for the cover. That's one and a kick out of one by Wicker. I mean, it was nice, but it wasn't nice enough to keep this woman down. Jinx, you got to stay in the driver's seat. Stay in control. What you got in mind? Grabs her. Look at this. Look at this. Lifts her up for a fisherman suplex, but Wicker reverses into a small package. One, two, three. No, she nearly got her, but Jinx managed to get out with that big body weight on top of her. And look at Wicker just twisting the wrist. Oh my god, look at her lifting her up by her wrist. Oh my god, Jinx. Oh my god, just drops Jinx down. Look at Jinx holding her arm and shoulder. I think she nearly ripped it out of the socket. Wicker kicks at the abdomen. And Jinx on her knee, but Wicker picks her up and just knees her in the face. She doesn't even try, man. Wicker just playing with her food right now as she picks Jinx up. Kick to the abdomen. Look at this. Oh my god. Pump handle. Pump handle slam. Oh no. Jinx got over and pulls her legs out. Look at this, Jinx. Look at this. Runs in. Twists her out. What the hell? An orthodox pin. Grabbing the legs. One with the bridge. Two. Three. Oh, she nearly got her. This is the unorthodox style of Jinx. What makes her so effective. And you can't help but behind her. Clothesline from Jinx. Runs in at a back elbow. Taking Wicker off her feet. Look at this Irish whip. But Wicker reverses it with the strength of her. Running in. Oh, she moved out the way. Look at this kick from the apron. What's she got in mind? Springboard. Forward smash. She takes Wicker down. All that body weight. All that momentum for the cover. Could she pin her? One, two, three. Wicker kicks out. It's not enough. Jinx. Using her advantage, using her speed, using her technique, using her tactics. Oh, she's going for the candy floss elbow. She's going for the candy floss elbow. We saw this last show. We saw this of two shows ago. Candy floss elbow, and she nails it, plants it into the chest. And now she's taunting Wicker up. She's taunting Wicker up to her feet. What's she got in mind? Jinx twisting the arm, but Wicker punches her. It's not effective. Wicker, no. Irish whip into the corner. Runs in, punch. Clothesline, grabbing Jinx. Iris whips her into the corner and follows straight in with another clothesline. Look at this. One arm, side slam, plants her into the mat. Vicious from Wicker for the cover. One, two, it's over. Three, Jinx gets her shoulder up. What a match from these two so far. Jinx putting everything she can into this, but no. Twisting the arm, Jinx rolls out of it. Scissor sweep, drop, toe hold, reversal. What's Jinx got in mind? Forearm smash. Jinx fighting back. She pulls her out, throws Wicker to the outside. What's Jinx got in mind? Look at this, Jinx, off the rope. Jinx, 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 drop, oh, drop kick, holding the top rope. Knocks Wicker off the feet, off her feet with the power of a torpedo. And Jinx picking Wicker up, rolls her into the ring. This could be what she needs. After a torpedo drop kick through the top rope, holding onto it for the cover. One, two, three, no, Wicker. Wicker will not die. She will not stay down. What has Jinx got to do to keep her down? Jinx picking Wicker up. Look at this under the arm. Oh, back suplex. He couldn't really pick her up enough, but she kips up. And Jinx, so unorthodox in her offense. This is what she needs as she picks Wicker up. What has she got in mind? Kick, 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 kick. Oh, my God. Kick in the face from Jinx. Beautifully done as she's picking Wicker up to her feet. What's she gonna do now? Look at this. Wicker tries to grab her, but Jinx rolls her through. Jinx rolls her through for the cover. Steal it. One, two. Jinx is going to. Three. No. Wicker kicks out. It's not enough. Jinx lining her up. Runs in. Wicker. Oh my God. Tilt the World Backbreaker. Just shutting down all momentum, and this is not looking good for Jinx. And look at this. Looking the arm over for a suplex. Goldbuster as he slams her down, crushing the ribs and chest. And Jinx is just trying to get up to her feet, and this is not looking good. And Wicker twists the arm, but Jinx rolls out of it again. But Wicker runs in. Wicker runs in. Slams her down with a modified stomach breaker. This is not looking good for Jinx. Oh, no. No. Scarecrow driver. Scarecrow driver. And right on the top of the head and neck for the cover from Wicker. One, two, three. And Wicker puts Jinx away with the scarecrow driver. And Wicker goes through in the Women's Championship Tournament. I think Jinx did so well considering the circumstances. There was moments where I thought she had it in the bag. I thought she was going to steal it. She used her ability. She used her toolbox. She used everything she had to fight this woman. But tonight, Wicker proved dominant. Tonight, Wicker proved powerful. Tonight, Wicker proceeds to the next round of the XWF Women's Championship Tournament. Ladies and gentlemen, what is Wicker gonna bring to the table in this tournament? Exciting times. And wait a minute, oh my, Athena's at the entrance, man. She's at the Tron and she's walking down. She's cut her music, literally cut Wicker's music for Athena's music, and Athena's walking down. We've just seen what Wicker can do in the ring. We've just seen how dominant she was, and Athena's just coming down with attitude, with aggression. She beat Penny Jacobs earlier tonight, and Athena just walking up. Look at this, getting in the ring. Wicker ain't moving, and Athena just walks up, and these two dominant behemoths just looking at each other. Oh man, oh man, this is hyper, man. This is hype. I'm feeling it. Athena and Wicker just staring at each other in the eyes. No fear from between these two. No fear of each other. Wicker just looking at Athena. Athena just looking at Wicker, and neither of these two women are backing down. Neither of them are backing down. You can feel the fire in this crowd, man. Just staring each other down, and Athena leaves. Athena leaves. She's left her. She's come out. She's done what she wanted to do, which was look Wicker in the eyes and show Wicker that she has no fear of Wicker. But you know what? Wicker did the exact same thing to Athena, and Wicker's just watching as Athena leaves. These two behemoths, and Athena's just looking back. Man, 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 oh my God. It's like King Kong versus Godzilla, man. Let's look at the Women's Championship run-ins. Banshee and Celeste in bracket one, Athena and Wicker in bracket two. My God, we've got some big women's matches coming up, ladies and gentlemen. Let's look at them. Celeste versus Banshee. You know, these guys have got history. Celeste has never beaten Banshee. Can she beat her in the tournament when it matters? And Athena versus Wicker. Battle of the Dominations. Dominations. I'm excited, man. Who's going to come out on top of that? Let me know. Let me know your predictions for those matches. Ladies and gentlemen, we are moving on to our main event of this evening, XWF Shockwave 54. We'll see XWF legend, Dr. Khan, going one-on-one with the man that calls himself the West, yo, with the man that calls himself the Squared Circle King, with the man that calls him the Messiah of the Squared Circle, with the man that calls himself Drake Planet, with the man that has about 800 other freaking nicknames that I can't recite off the top of my head right now. He will be facing this man, Dr. Effin' Khan. Dr. Khan, man, this guy arguably has the best record in XWF when it comes to main event matches, when it comes to big fight feels. Can he win tonight going against this guy who's hungry? This guy said he's hungry. He wants to prove how good he is. And we know how good this guy is. He's one of the best kept wrestlers in the company. He is arguably the greatest XWF internet champion we have ever had, with two incredible reigns. This guy has win after 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 win. If he beats Dr. Corn tonight, I think it would be fair to say that Jacob Drake is well and truly in the running for a shot at the XWF World Heavyweight Championship. But that is no easy task. And Drake knows it, but he looks ready. He looks raring for action. He looks focused, like always. That's the thing with Jacob Drake. He's got this persona. You know, he puts on this West, yo, this gimmick, this gangster, whatever you want to call it, and people call him out for it. Some people call him a Mario Sanchez ripoff. This guy would rip the frickin' head off, man. Jacob Drake is an incredible talent. I might not like the guy. You can't deny his technique in the ring. Can he beat Dr. Corn tonight? I don't know. But that's what the main event's for. Let's get the show on the road. Dr. Corn, Jacob Drake, locking horns. That's what I'm talking about. And Dr. Corn using his strength to push Jacob Drake back into the corner, asserting dominance on the Messiah of the Squared Circle. And the referee's like, break it up, break it up, break it up. And it's a fair breakup. Locking horns again. Who's the stronger man? Who's the stronger man? Jacob Drake goes around for a waist lock. Look at this. Dr. Corn trying to find a way out. Snapmare from Dr. Corn. You want a chain match, Dr. Corn? I'll give you a chain match, man. Jacob Drake grabs the wrist. Nice. Did you see that technique? Puts it into a top wrist lock. Knee in the stomach. Knee in the stomach. Jacob Drake playing the dirty, man. Playing the dirty. Dr. Corn really trying to use his strength to find a way out, and he does into a hammerlock, into a side headlock. Put in the pressure on Jacob Drake, and he's fighting. You want to fight, man? Corn will fight you. Elbow on the back of the head. Jacob Drake pushing Dr. Corn against the rope, bounces him off the ropes while the gun might sleep from Jacob Drake. Goes to grab him, but Corn pushes him down to the floor. An elbow into the elbow, scouting him out. Dr. Corn with the Irish whip, launches him into the corner, runs in, goes to close to Drake! Oh my god! Dropped him onto the top rope, guillotine style. One, two, and a kick out on two by Dr. Corn. It was good. Don't get me wrong, it was good. But it wasn't enough to keep down Dr. Corn. Jacob Drake's got to do a lot more clubbing punches here. Jacob Drake, these little boxing fists. Irish whipping Corn into the corner. Now he's just wearing Corn's kidneys down with these strikes, bludgeoning and bruising him. And look at Jacob Drake getting all cocky. Getting all cocky. Goes to grab Corn. Corn ain't taking it. Puts him into place. Punch, 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 punch from Corn. Just clubbing fists. Corn grabs him by the leg. What the hell? Oh my god, that's a Corn. That's Corn. Reverse alley. Oh my god, Alabama slammer. Vicious from Dr. Corn. That could be it. You pissed Dr. Corn off. You get it, man. One, two, three, and a kick out just before that three by Jacob Drake. He nearly had him, though. Jacob Drake getting cocky, and Corn freaking snapped. He wasn't having any of it, and a pissed off Corn is a bad Corn for Jacob Drake. Wrestling takedown from the doctor. Jake trying to get up to his feet, but he's put Corn in a bad mood now, and Corn is going to take this out on him. Look at that. Look at that strength. Body slam from Dr. Corn kicks him in the back. You might be the Messiah of the Squared Circle, but this is Dr. Corn, the single most efficient and effective, the single most successful wrestler in the XWF when it comes to main event matches. And you're in one with him right now. Dr. Corn taking some time to taunt to the fans now when it's safe. Unlike Jacob Drake, goes for a punch, but Jake blocks it. Drake goes for a punch, but Corn blocks it and kicks him in the abdomen. Corn runs in and clotheslines and cuts through like a knife through hot butter. Corn picking Jacob Drake up to his feet. Kick to the abdomen. Drake blocks it and kicks him in the thigh. Drake with a fist like a stone in the face there. And he pushes Corn to the ground. Step off, and he stamps on the chest cavity. And that is enough to wind even the strongest and biggest man. And Jacob Drake kicks Corn in the back of the leg. And Corn goes to his knees. Kick. Kick across the chest. Kick across the chest. And Jacob Drake kick across the face. Viciously done. And Jacob Drake's torn into the fans, man. He's torn into the fans now. Showboating as he picks Corn up to his feet. Look at this headlock takedown. Vintage, classic. Jacob Drake applying pressure to the jaw and the neck and wrenching it, but Corn rolls him out of desperation. But he's holding his head. You can feel that hurting, man. Drake kicks him up, but Corn kicks him in the abdomen, grabs the arm. Look at this, all vintage. Dr. Corn with the master cradle pin for the cover. One, two, three. No, Jacob Drake gets a shoulder up. It's not enough. Corn up to his feet, runs in, goes for a clothesline, but Drake blocks it, goes for a clothesline. Corn ducked it, but Drake left arm clothesline right in the back of the head. He scouted it, he saw it coming, and then reacted. And that's what Jacob Drake is so good with, his reactions, elbow dropping Corn repeatedly in the chest. And now Drake just getting cocky, man, as Corn's trying to get up to his feet, reeling off those vicious elbow drops in the chest cavity. Corn tried to grab him, but Drake reversed it, drops him onto his knee, and then hits him with a vicious neck breaker. The Messiah of the Squared Circle, the West, yo, one, two, three, and Corn gets a shoulder up just before the three. It's not enough to keep him down. Main event rages on here tonight on Shockwave 54. Jacob Drake going with these strike combinations on the doctor. Irish whip draws him back in and knees him in the abdomen. And the Corn is feeling this, man. Corn is feeling this. Jacob Drake picks Khan up to his feet, kick to the abdomen again, punch in the side of the head, viciously done, controlling the pace. Jacob Drake grabs him, but Khan fighting back with a kick to the abdomen. This is what he needs. Goes for a whip, but Drake reverses it, draws him in and knees him in the abdomen again. Cuts down the momentum of the doctor, and this is where Jacob Drake is at his best. It's when he's in control of the pace, when he's in control. But Khan fights back with a punch to the abdomen. Khan throws the arm over. Khan, big suplex, and he slams him down with stalling power. And Jacob Drake roll into the apron to try and get some breathing space, but Khan sees him. He's watching him like his eyes like a hawk. Throws the arm over, and another suplex, lifting him up, and he slams him down with a second suplex from Dr. Khan. Leg hooks for the cover. 1, 2, 3, and Jacob Drake kicks out. It's not enough. It is not enough. What a main event so far from these two men. Jacob Drake proving that he can hang with the doctor. He goes for a clothesline to Khan. Ducked under it and ran in with 100 power force. 100 miles per hour. Just cut through Jacob Drake's face. This is where it gets dangerous for Jacob Drake. His Khan just punches him in the abdomen. And again, Drake trying to roll out the ring. Trying to roll to safety, but Khan ain't having it. Punch to the face. Look at this, Khan, head under the arm. Look at this, back suplex from Dr. Khan, angled for precision. And Dr. Locke, he's got the Dr. Locke locked in, the signature submission, and he's applying, and he's wrenching, and he's pulling back on the head of Jacob Drake. And we've seen big guys tap out to this move. We've seen Big D tap out to this move. We've seen Inferno tap out to this move. Dr. Khan has submitted many a wrestler with this move in his time, and he is applying the pressure, and he's getting the torque in, and he's got his knee right in the precision point of your back and your neck and your spine. Look at Khan's face. He's really applying the pressure. Jacob Drake can't take this much more. Jacob with a knee to the face. Drake with a knee to the face, and he fights out of it somehow. Drake runs in with a forearm smash. Somehow he's still alive. Forearm smash again. Khan up to his feet. Sling blade from Jacob Drake. Jacob Drake for the cover. Is he going to beat the doctor? 1, 2, 3. Dr. Khan gets a shoulder up. It's not enough. My God, what a main event as these two wage war tonight on Shockwave 54. Jacob Drake scooping out the legs, putting all his body weight. He's trying to steal it. 1, 2. He's going to steal it. 3. Dr. Khan gets a shoulder up. It's not enough. 2.9. Jacob Drake knowing he's got to stay on the attack. Massive fist there. Kick to the abdomen. But Khan blocks it. Oh, and it ends with Guri after block kick. Jacob Drake taking the fight to Khan. Look at this. He's got it. Watch it from his neck break. And he nails the signature maneuver. He nails the signature maneuver. Leg hooked. He's going to beat the doctor tonight. 1, 2, 3. Khan gets a shoulder rub. Look at Drake's face. He can't believe it. Dr. Khan kicks out of the world's most infamous neckbreaker, the signature maneuver of Jacob Drake. Jacob Drake's got to go bigger. He's got to go harder. He's got to use a Drake break. He's got to use a player hater. He's got to use the best moves he's got. Little left jab there. Jacob Drake pulls Khan out, puts him on the ropes. Look at Jacob Drake. Runs, steps off his back, pulls him down with a hot shot. Jacob Drake, innovative offense for the cover. Could that be over? 1, putting out all the moves. 2, 3. No, Dr. Khan gets a shoulder up again from the Jacob Drake hot shot. Classic move, but it's not enough to keep the doctor down in the main event. Like I said, Dr. Khan gets an extended freaking health bar or some crap in the main event. So consistent, arm jacking Dr. Khan, and he's fighting back, throwing fists like stones, like fists like bricks, and he picks Jacob Drake up, drops him onto the top rope. This is the comeback that the doctor needed. This is the comeback that he needed, and he's feeling it, he's vibing it, runs in, belly to belly suplex from Dr. Khan. Vintage DK as he picks Jacob Drake up. And here we go again, belly-to-belly suplex. You know, Reverend Al might have belly-to-bellies. Manga might have belly-to-bellies. Sean Savage might have belly-to-bellies. But Dr. Khan's got belly-to-belly suplexes for days. Three of them in a row. And Jacob Drake crushed. And Khan picking Jacob Drake up again. Clothesline. Khan's on fire. The energy's back. The momentum's back. Clothesline again. Drake goes for a kick. Khan blasts it. Spins around. Kicks out the back of his leg. Khan's on fire. Khan's energized. This is his moment. This is what Khan is so good at doing. He's throwing Jacob Drake up. Saw stethoscope kick. Stethoscope kick in the chest cavity of Jacob Drake. And Jacob Drake's winded. He's trying to get up to his feet. But you know what this means? Khan punches him. Khan locks it in. Goes for an operation, but Jacob Drake fights out. Punches him in the back of the head. Throws him into the turnbuckle. This is a bad position for Khan, because you know what this means as he turns him around. Punch in the face. Khan goes down into position. Jacob Drake, the player hater. He's about to put the doctor away. The player hater. Khan gets up and stethoscope kick again. Oh my God. Stethoscope kick. Khan got up to his feet so quick, man. How does he do it? Jacob Drake's dazed. He doesn't know where he is. Khan gets him. Operation. Lifting him up. Operation. And he nails it. Dr. Khan, leg hooked for the cover. 1, 2, 3 and Dr. Korn defeats Jacob Drake here tonight on XWF Shockwave 54's main event. What a match. I know you don't like the guy, I don't like the guy, but Jacob Drake just freaking went one-on-one with Dr. Korn and nearly had him on multiple occasions, but it was not enough to beat Dr. Korn, arguably the single most persistent and consistent guy in XWF main events, in XWF big match fields, big match fights, big matches. Dr. Korn's your man, your go-to guy, and once again, he has proved that he can do what he says he can. And wait a minute, damages music! Korn's ready, man, he'll fight you, he's just had a main event, you wanna go again? Let's do it! Korn will do it, man, Korn will not back down from damage. These guys do not get on. Wait, that's Sean Savage! What's he coming out to damage his music for? You know, these guys got enough bad blood as it is from no turning back, and Savage just smiling at Dr. Korn. Just smiling, and Korn staring back at him. He ain't intimidated. Damage with a chair! Oh my god! Sean Savage was a distraction! Korn just took a chair to the ribs, and Damage is just looking at him. Korn's trying to get up to his feet. Korn's trying to get up to his feet, and another shot to the ribs. Damage, no! DDT on the chair from Damage! On Dr. Korn. Korn's trying to get up somehow. Climbing up those ropes. Clothesline over the top rope from Damage. Oh my god. Damage leaving his mark on Dr. Korn. Use Sean Savage with Damage's music as a distraction. Korn's still trying to get up to his feet, man, but he can't do it. And Damage just standing on the turnbuckle torn into the fans. That is despicable, man. That is despicable. Korn had a freaking great match against Jacob Drake. Beat him fair and square. Korn, look at him, man. He's crawling. He's battered. Two chair shots and a DDT onto a chair, and then he freaking clotheslined him over the top rope. And Damage is just reveling in it. He's reveling in it. That's the XWF champion there, and he's reveling in it. Disgusting. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us for XWF Shockwave 54. If you're in the live chat, please interact. Leave me some comments, let us know what you thought of the show. If you're watching on playback as well, please leave us some comments. Thank you so much for your time. Get to the UCT Wiki, get on Twitter, support all your favorite UCT promotions. We need your likes, subscribes, your time, your comments, everything, man. It's much appreciated from everyone in the community. I'm the Bear, thank you so much for joining us. I think we're going to have a lot to go on our next show. It's an anniversary show. It's XWF Shockwave 55. And I think we are going to have an absolutely incredible match. So I'm the Bear. Thank you for tuning in. And peace out.